Among the wartime production feats of which the United States is pardonably proud, not least are those which have led to a spectacular rise in the nation's birth rate. In the period between Pearl Harbor and VJ Day, wartime marriages and boomtime incomes were responsible for a bumper crop of more than 10 million babies, almost 3 million more than these years might normally have been expected to produce. For some time to come, that most demanding and baffling of all age groups, the 1 to 5-year-olds, will inevitably claim a greatly increased share of the nation's time, attention, and money. Most American parents are thoroughly impressed with the importance of regular care as insurance for their children's health. Frequent checkups on physical growth and development by parents as well as by pediatricians are an established part of the routine of most properly cared for babies. But that the child's mind and personality also need regular checking is an idea still dramatically new to most parents. It is this idea which underlies Yale University's Clinic of Child Development, pioneer and leader in the new science of infant behavior. Here, for 35 years, a group of child specialists have been diligently at work charting the behavior patterns of children from every kind of environment, in order to establish some standard of development to serve as a yardstick by which parents, teachers, and doctors may better understand the child's mental growth. After years of cooperative research and experimentation, the various progressive stages of mental growth, 34 in all in the normal child, have been identified by Dr. Arnold Gesell, founder and head of the clinic.
The mind manifests itself in patterns of behavior which take on characteristic shapes throughout infancy and childhood. We have identified the behavior patterns which may be used as standards of reference in the clinical diagnosis of child development. When you observe the work of this clinic, you will see how these diagnostic standards are applied.
For their studies, Dr. Gesell and his staff have devised a one-way vision dome which conceals from the child those who are watching him. Gesell's findings, carefully documented in pictures and in written records, reveal that in the growth of their minds and physical skills, most normal children follow a startlingly similar pattern of development. Tests of the 4-week-old infant show that he has little physical control. His hands remain clenched, and he grasps objects only by reflex action. He has not yet achieved much coordination of head and eye movements. He can fix his eyes on a moving object, but he has not yet learned how to turn his head from the side position, which is natural at this age. His exploration of the world around him begins with his eyes. Later, it will continue with eyes and hands. At 4 months, the baby can turn his head from side to side and hold it in mid-position. He can also consciously bring his hands together, a thing which would have been impossible for him at 4 weeks. At this age, the normal child is barely beginning to coordinate his eyes and hands. He fixes his eyes on objects presented to him, but he makes no move to pick them up, for this simple action involves a more complex mental process than he is yet capable of. But the child